Yes, I'll be full tonight.
Yeah,
Peter, what's your feelings about this car, this game and bat?
I think the boys are going to do very well indeed.
Yeah?
Yesterday.
No swearing or anything like that?
Swearing at all. Bad language.
Not like Barber.
Not like Barber, no need for it. It only shows a lack of vocabulary.
Stuff you're 18, it's been yours.
Ready.
18-year-old, that is it? So that's my bell boys, that is. Mission tape recorder.
I can pick eight forwards to start, boys. four forwards to go on the bench. So I got three backs on the bench, right? It's awful hard. I've been having sleepless nights for fucking for 2 weeks already over this, right? It's a difficult thing, boys. I will try and speak to the people that I think they might be involved and will be upset by it. But look, don't shout about it, boys, because I'm only doing what I see the right one for that day. Nothing personal, nothing that I don't like him or I don't like him, right? It's what I see right for the day. Yeah? And that's what it's down to, boys. Like, Di coming to some flack of late. But boys, you can't be doing that bad a fucking selection job. We won 40 league games on the fucking trot. You know, most people start mourning when the coaches start and the team starts losing. So just bear in mind, boys, right? Because I know, like, I know, Alan, you want to be there.
Yeah.
You want to be there. You want to be there. Stuart, you want to be there. Yeah. It's fucking hard, boys, but I can't put everybody there. Not like I want to, but I can't, right? So I apologise before it. I can only pick what I can pick, right? Thursday after training, don't arrange to go anyway, you're going up the club, the selected squad, going up the club to get your kit, not your jerseys, your socks, shorts, coats, whatever, right? The club have put a lot of time and effort into this, boys. Honest to God, I was at a committee meeting last night, I go home about 20 to fucking 11. A lot of effort. People are putting out, brought the generators and lights tonight. People are putting themselves out. And people are doing it because they think we can fucking beat these. Scrum 5 said to me on the, and I'm not lying to you boys, we're coming to you because we think you can cause an upset. I believe we can beat them. I honestly do, in my heart of hearts, believe we can beat them. But I'm telling you now, boys, it's the worst feeling in the world on a Sunday when all your family sat down watching you get fucking hammered on Scrum 5. I'm telling you now, the worst feeling in the world. You chase everything, you hit everything, you name every motherfucker which comes near you. We do not take a backward step, not to any bastard. We haven't conceded one fucking try in 3 games, not one. Nobody penetrates our line. I don't give a if it's fucking Cardiff, the Nestle, fucking Romney. It doesn't matter. If you hit the man like you fucking do every week, they will not penetrate. They will not. But you've got to sell your heart and your fucking soul to it, boys. Heart and fucking soul. Everything this week has got to be geared to that fucking 80 minutes. Everything. Yeah? Every fucking thing. We get to training Thursday, we'll be queued up. We switched on, and let's take these motherfuckers Saturday. Yeah? Let's take them. Let's let everybody be proud of us, and let's be proud of each other. Yeah? We've come a fucking long way, boys. A long way. Everybody in fucking Flower says to me every fucking week, are you, who are you playing? Who are you playing? Well, let's show them. We can play any team. On our part, anybody, and we can fucking take them. We can fucking take them, I'm telling you. Let's be up for it, boys. Fucking Thursday, we'll start, and we're going to rumble onto that fucking field Saturday, and we're going to hit them with fucking, not a kitchen sink, we're going to fucking chuck a bus at the tent as well. Come on, let's fucking do it. Come on, lads.
If I got Edgy's pace or fucking some guy's pace, I'll do this. Do him, I'll fucking take it. Donkeys like me and you never do that. Because as soon as I go like this, that's the easiest fucking tackle in the world. He's going to hit me right there. I'm showing him my fucking hip. I told him as well, but didn't I? I'm showing him my hip. If he's going to tackle me, and I'm going to pace, I'm going to fucking run straight at him. That's the hardest tackle of all. If he goes low, I'm going to bounce him off. Stop fucking showing your fucking size to people. It's so easy to tackle. Unless you've got fucking massives and massives of class and talent. Right? I haven't got a lot of talent. Alright? I've got a fucking big heart. And there's boys who have got lots of talent. There's boys like me as well. Not a lot of talent. Right? So if you're one of these boys, don't show somebody your talent. You fucking go front on. It's the hardest tackle to make. Nobody likes tackling somebody when they need to come into work this day. You get it wrong, you fuck. Right? So if you're, I got to my grunt as same as me, right? You've got fucking arms as big as our chest, but I've got a lot of fucking, you got no fat in everything, that's all. But if he shows me his fucking side, I'll knock him down every time. Every time. If he shows me his side, I'll knock him down every time. I don't want to tackle him front on. Because he fucking elbowed me in the face, he knee me in the fucking edge, it's the same. The rest of you, Darren, some of you got fucking pace, like Oscar and Darren, you can do different things. You can fucking go around with people who can spot sides up. That's fair enough. But don't show, James, you run so sad, you put the ball, you run up to that guy, and you went straight across the shit. I'm not picking on Jenks, but you pick up the key. Let's go.
Yeah.
The fucking late comers. Oh, do me a favor, bud. Shut the fuck up. Thank you.
learn two or three interrupts, there'll be experiences for you. You know? You won't fucking commit then. You send the boys up the fucking middle. Have said that they're getting stuck in two minds because of the space that's appearing inside, right? So I just want to verify what the situation is. Off a line out, Mag, do we fucking want? Smicko can fill the gap. I'm worried about this first channel, Smick, right? Now to half goal, switches with the centre, and he's going to come right down the fucking galley, right?
They're not going to...
Yeah, off a line out, that can happen, because you can get there, right? He'll take care of the fucking scrum up. You fill that gap, because... And it's on a push defence, right? Jamie will tell you, because man for man, you can do whatever you fucking like, I couldn't care less, right? But on a push defence, Smick, you've got to fill that gap off a line out, right? Because if Jamie goes across and the outside half switches to the centre, he's going with the outside half. Because Grunt is going to be out there on his man, and the outside half, either go straight to the gap or Jamie takes him, which leaves the centre. The centre comes back, he's going to run right down the middle unless you want to stop him. Right? And that's what. I want to say, Mikko, you're clear why it's well, because we don't want to pitch up to say, ah, we fucked it up. Because if we do all do the same thing, then everything will work, right? Yeah. So, Mikko's job, off a line out, see, on defence, if he shouts push one, you stand there and have our first chance. Either the 10 is going to have a go himself, or 12 is going to come back. A winger will be picked up by our winger. Alright? Right. The second fucking scenario is the scrum. Now, Smicko's going to be on the open side on scrum. If Jamie says we're playing a push one defence, you are not going to be able quick enough to get up and fill that space. So, Mag, it's got to be you. Right? Right? It's got to be you who takes 10. Now, I know you're a fucking battling cunt for that scrum half, right? And we haven't done it against Rumby and things like that because he battled the scrum half fucking superbly, right? But if that 10 of there starts to suss us out, he'll come flying down there, especially off the scrum, because there's more space and you're going to be harder to get up, right? Mag, it's only going to do it for a couple of seconds, just till you get there. And then he's free to do where he fucking wants.
If you put in so much pressure on the scrum half,
what I is saying, and this is what you've got to understand, right? This is the fucking scenario, Saturday. They won't have one or two fast men in behind. They'll all be fast. You miss a tackle, you give the space, and you won't stag them like normally. Somebody will pick them up normally. Dan will run back, stag them, whoever. Saturday, you ain't going to. So unless we're all fucking going to what I is saying, then they get
gapped. The other thing is, lads, right? Whatever, I mean, you know what fucking super players, but as you've got buddies, this is the system we play. This is the system we've got to play. Smicko filled there, Steve all that coaching, they take care of whatever they want to. But you've got to fill that gap. It's only for a couple of seconds until fucking Margaret gets it.
Fred, and you can go do whatever you fucking want.
What area do you want to play that defensive? Which one?
Well, it'll be up the field, won't it? When it's man for man in our 22, you know, right? Outside 22. Anything else you do, the fuck you want. I couldn't care less. What I'm worried about is, Mouse is going to go across on a push one, and that's all.
Come on!
You're doing my fucking head in now. Right, I'm telling you now, right? Get it on! Yeah? Whoop, being like he is fucking about and laughing because he's not in the starting 15. That's how fucking life is. Yeah? Yeah? But for you, take some fucking pride in it, yeah? And for them who haven't made it, just take pride in it. Come on, please. I'm all you do for fucking first this year. Yeah? Cardiff for fucking 10 years ago. That's like playing Cardiff Blues. This is fucking Cardiff under 21s with a couple of good fucking players in amongst them. Coming to the Bargoed, who haven't fucking lost at home for 3 years. It's them wankers who should be frightened, not fucking us. And you make sure they are fucking frightened before they get out there by being fucking queued up and switched on 110%. You don't want to be there. You don't want to be on the bench or anything like that. Tell me now, you don't have to. I'll put some fucking little desk. But I'm not having it, boys. We've worked too fucking hard and too long to chuck it away now. Then Saturday, we will prove a fucking point to everybody. Yeah, 110. Boys, you win the squad.
Boys, we can win.
Keep up a kiss tomorrow night, boys. There's a lot of people at our parties and work at us.
He's the master of winding people up. I got a different kind of approach. A coach done this for me once, and I kept it for fucking ages, that for seasons. But I'm not saying that my words are going to be as good as this, but some of you might think it's a lot of bollocks. By all means, rip it up, chuck in the bin, and call me a cunt on Saturday night. I don't really mind, all right? But I thought long and hard, and my feelings were, if I try and say something to you, it's going to be off the top of my head. If I sit at home at the computer
the end of each one, there's a little quote, lads, that I've got, which I think sums everybody, sums you up. But please check each other if you like, they're not all the fucking same, right? I've written different things and I've spent, what, shut the fuck up. I spent one night thinking about each player and wrote down what I thought. And Gary, this one for you, mate, and love it. Might not be able to judge what I think of you, right? The situation with you and him, I don't either recall the club now. I'll get you, kid. Whoever's playing Saturday, I'll get you. I don't have any kids because it's not fucking me. The rest of us.
I just saw triple XL. Panic.
You want quadruple XL? What?
Okay, boys, let's have a listen up there. Cardiff's going to say a few words and present the jerseys first, so that's what's all from now on, is it? Have a good day.
Say hello, it's Steve's brother, and we want to get this over and done with as quick as we can. But Steve asked if I'd say a couple of words before the game. I jumped at the chance. It's been 22 years since the club have had anything like today. It's a big day. Big, really big day for the spectators, supporters and members. We've got the field now, it looks superb. The guy came up this morning and bought 20 tickets for me this morning. It's that big a day. We've been up here since 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, buying tickets, doing everything. It is a big day. But thanks, Steve and I, they got us here. I'm going to say us. Us as a club, you as players, they got us here. It is a big day for them, for you lot especially. The last time we said we had one of these was 22 years ago. I was fucking 17 standing on the touchline. So they don't come around very often. And that? it's a one-off occasion for a lot of it. A lot of you are going to hopefully aspire to a lot more things, and I'm sure you'll get there. Right? You're a little part that can take you on the way and get to it.
Yeah.
Today, these shirts, all I want on, they're yours to keep.
All right,
do me a favour, boys, I'll ask you to do one thing. Don't wear them training, I don't swap them or anything, because they're the one-off, they're a special shirt for you. There's not going to be any more going about like it is. And that's all I got to ask to say is thank you all for getting us here as a squad. A lot of youngsters in here. Let's have an enjoyable day, is it?
Come on, Steve, get your fucking hand on it.
Try
not limping
up.
Put it on again. Right, from.
What do you want there? Go, Bernie.
Steve had a phone call this morning from little Di Jones. He's in New Zealand. And I've got two monologues to read out to you, lads, right? Two sheets, says Steve. Right? Just have a little think about these words, right? Having played in four successive cup finals for Bridgend between 1979 and 1982, I hope that the following two pointers can help you have a successful day on Saturday. Number one, motivation should not be a problem. Number two, hopefully an enthusiastic vocal home crowd will be worth 7 to 8 points. Number three, you are a well-prepared fit side, and just because you were playing Cardiff for City Slickers, self-belief must continue to be paramount importance. Number four, even a very successful side like Bridgend at the time, when we won the cup against Pontypridd and then Swansea, in the first rounds of a successful campaign, we almost lost in the snow to Mountain Ash in 1979 and Aberforth West in 1980. This truly indicates the possibility of a smaller club being successful. Number five, continue the match day preparation on Saturday as in any other normal game. Do not deviate. Number six, 80 minutes will go very quickly due to the euphoria of the occasion. Concentration, commitment and application of skill will be crucial. Number seven, the whole occasion is to be enjoyed, such as the atmosphere, and allow yourself to be taken on a ride. Danger warning, lad. I'm not aware who the referee is, but be prepared for any 50-50 decisions to go in favour of Cardiff. Good analysis. And finally, very best wishes from Webb James and everybody at Rummy Rugby. One last word. There should always be an upset in the cup. Let's make sure it's our game today. I always remember playing for Cross Keys in the 70s, and we did the double over Newport. I'm not sure which gave me more satisfaction, winning or the looks on those bastard townies' faces. Go out and do it today, boys. Make history. That's from Dave Cribb, who's an ex-Bargoed coach and player. Right, lads? Enjoy it, lads. It's not too big for you. Let's come off with no regrets, yeah? No regrets. I don't even want to warm up on a field, I want to go up the top and warm up. No going to warm up on outfield, boys, we go up the top and go in. I don't want them to see us, and we're not going to fucking see them. We'll see them when it comes to the fucking battle. Yeah? You want to know them, you don't want to know fuck all about them. There's nothing, nothing better than we are, boys. Fuck all better than us, right? They haven't got the records we got, they got fuck all, right? Nothing to be frightened of. And in our first scrum today, we're going to fucking show them we're not fighting. We're going to fucking ram it right down that. And if they collapse the fuck out, we go straight over them and we kick the fuck out of them. Right? You start the scene fucking early. Get up the changing rooms, right? Bus is ready. What time have you got the changing rooms? About half past 12?
Yeah, half past 12.
We get on the bus, we get up there, boys. Get all your strapping done because normally we'll be able to run from where we're warming up down all the fucking time like you like to do, Lou. We're up there. We're staying up here for this tight to come down, right? It's going to be a huge crowd up there, boys. Some of you haven't played in front of a huge crowd before. But don't come back in that change room regretting anything, boys. Yeah? Don't think, oh, fuck it, I shouldn't have kicked it. I should have fucking run that. I should have went for it. But fucking go for it. I'd much rather lose today and we've gone for it then we lose by a couple of points because we've been cagey as fuck. It's not the way we do things, boys. It's not us. Let's fucking have a go at them and beat them at what we fucking do best. Yeah? All about confidence and self-belief, boys. It's a day to be fucking enjoyed, but enjoying it is fucking giving them a good game or fucking winning. Getting stuffed, that's not an enjoyment, boys. That ain't gonna happen today. I'm telling you now, boys, it's not like fucking playing Cardiff of 5 years ago. That's the Blues, that is.
fucking Cardiff fucking rat. We're playing. And play fuck all the US Blackwood, Bargoed won't be fucking Cardiff fucking rat. So don't be worried about it, boys. Fuck up. Let's go out and let's fucking give it to them. Yeah? There's no fucking fear factor. All your families will be there, everybody's gonna be there. But do it for who's in this fucking room. This is what fucking counts. Who's in this fucking room? The boys you play bleed with every week. Three times a week. That last circle taken out, I'm afraid who's. The last second leg. Our defence, Dave mentioned in defence, we've gotta go with the patterns, boys. Don't fucking freeze out there. Don't fucking let all the things we spoke about go by you. That's the difference between big players and fucking average players, boys. Boys, you can take it on board in the big crunch games. This is fucking huge, boys. This is what we live for in life. Yeah, there is no bigger thing. You are die falling from New Zealand. First phone call I had this morning, die falling from New Zealand. I know lots of the boys know die, and lots of you don't. Die was okay at you when we first come up, yeah. His wife had a bit of a brain tumour and whatnot, and at one point she wasn't looking very fucking clever. We used to turn up every fucking week. Because as much as he loved his wife, he loved his family, he loved us as well. Right? Think of people like that, yeah? The boys who can't be here today. We fucking love to be here, yeah? That's what it's all about, isn't it? It's going to be a big day. It's going to be a big day. See? You know what I'm saying?
How exactly do you want us to warm up? On the top pitch or on the school pitch?
I reckon we'll go on our top pitch. I do.
Well, if we're going to do that, we need to get out on time together, lad, as a unit, not have scrapping going on and people foxing around. And let's all have the right attire on, yeah, the light blue training tops. All of us together, we all move out to one. I'm going to do the warm up. We all move back as one. See, can you help me out there, mate?
Yeah, no problem.
The light blue training tops, boys, anybody haven't got one? Straight away
running
the car,
right? Must be Newport Newbridge, but we never had a chance at this time of what we're today. This is the best that we've ever done for a long, long time. And it's all down to the players in the field. You can't do more, we can't do more. It's entirely up to Glenn and his boys to do what they've got to do to win this game.
Don't let it pass by, boys. Make your fucking mark on the game. So to come off and you're in the bar tonight, whatever happened, you can fucking stand tall and say, I did that, I did this. Didn't I look fucking good on the pitch? We all look good, and we all do the business. We're going to beat them both. We're going to win.
If I see any of you stood tall after 10 o'clock, me and Steve will not be fucking out. Right? If that's the type of night you'll be, boys, we put these to the fucking sword and tell him now, you'll have the best night of your life. And that, you know, fuck the sex and all the rest of it. You'll just have one of them big buzz nights with all the boys, first and second together, fucking getting hammered. And what a night you'll be on, boys. You won't come down for fucking weeks. I'll be making this job and fuck it, I'm looking forward to bringing you back.
Fucking hell.
Yeah. Nips are going to be hard today, Ginge.
I can always wait to bargain park.
Who's
one of the players, yeah? One of the players, yeah?
No, it's saying it's new, no, he seems pretty old.
Bargain food.
That's Barbara's eye, he's going to have to intimidate them.
Ginge, what's that for? Don't you make it too late?
Daniel, jacket, Danny. Hey, Danny, I like our jacket.
Oh, Ginger!
The water you had in his back.
Fence.
Oh, make sure you do a bit of filming, then.
Oh, be pocket man, then.
What's happening?
Takes off and you're leaving. Thank you.
It's on your leg, I'm back.
Aye, this looks good, though, doesn't it, when it's like this? So, hopefully then people...
Thanks, Fred.
It's another day in paradise.
This is bread and butter, boys. Bread and fucking butter.
Look at them fucking arms, boy.
That's the Peter Post, boy, please.
What do you want, John? Okay, pull the load out.
No, you can have that.
You're making what?
You want change?
Self-conscious.
Yeah, yeah. Man, are you cold?
It's fucking freezing. What's that? This is too bad.
Keep going! Two passes! Two! One! Two! 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 Two!
And here's Chrissy Morgan now, just waiting here for the BBC to arrive on this very special day in Bargoed Rugby Club history. And as you can see, he's a fine figure of a man. Looking rather cold here on the nether regions, Chris, but looking good, son. You are the warrior.
The warrior. Chrissy Morgan is my alter ego.
Oh, good talk, man. Go ahead.
Okay, Elvis is going now, please.
Elvis,
now you've got to stay. Elvis is going to Bargoed.
Uh-huh.
This is
going
on.
Is this?
Hang on, stay. Okay,
Chris, you even balls this up, lad.
Uh-huh. Elvis is going to Bargoed.
Ladies and gentlemen, Elvis is going to Bargoed. Uh-huh.
Good stuff, Chris.
Sit down. Boys, I don't want anybody behind me. I don't want people I can see. Guy's going to say a bit before we start. 15 minutes, that's all it is, lads.
15 minutes of war, boys.
15 minutes till we go into battle, boys, and we're going to give it a battle, right?
Boys, Steve will get you up for the game now, psychologically. I just want to say thanks for the 2.5 years that we've had, because, you know, for me and Barber, we finished our playing days, and we never thought we'd be in a situation where we'd be facing Cardiff, of all teams, on a day like today, and we were just going to go home and stay with our wives for the rest of our lives, you know, but this has given me something special in my life the last 2.5 years. I really enjoyed it, and I know he has as well. And I'm not saying you should do it for us or anything, but I just want to express my gratitude, not only to the people who are in this room, but to everybody involved with Bargoed, because it's the best club I've ever been in, buddy.
Lads, just to finish what I touched on then, Bargoed Rugby Club. 13 players involved in the squad that they started their rugby careers in Bargoed. A small town like this, and you going out to face Cardiff. That's something for the town to be proud of, and for you youngsters to be proud of. I'm proud of it, because we haven't had the money to go out and buy every bastard. We only got what we got here, which we brought up through. And now we're going to start. You'll have to leave now, mate.
Yes, no problem. Good luck, gents.
Thanks
for that.
Right, listen. And listen fucking good. One crack you get in fucking life. One crack. Today's our fucking chance. That a bunch of fucking kids. Fucking kids coming to take us on. And Bargoed never fucking happens. Nobody comes here. Nobody comes to our dead and fucks with us. We're gonna rip out a fucking bits. Strangle the bastard life out of them. Do not let them settle. Don't let them get their confidence up. Get into their faces and you take their fucking faces. Take them. First scrum, we take it to them. They drop it, we're over it.
If they want to get fucking funny, let's beat them up as well. So all today, boys. Them kids haven't beat the fucking battles like we have. They haven't had the battles in Fairwater. They haven't beat the bedlock and had fucking loads of stitches after game. You fucking lot have. You beat the fucking ass end of rugby. And you fought and you stood there and you fought and you fucking fought for each other. Now we got a glory. And now we're going to take that fucking glory.
Oh, yeah. Take it, you fucking...
Take it! Come on!
Come on!
Come on!
Come on!
Come on!
Come on!
Drink it.
Come on!
Come on! Come on!
Come on!
Oh, come on!
No fucking respect for this! No fucking respect!
Come on!
No fucking respect!
Come on,
then!
People go up there, they fucking banshees! The fucking 15 of us! Just get up here and he's knocked your fucking down! He's fucking disruptive! He's killing their faces! They think it's fucking stupid, you think they? Because we've been knocking them fucking down all the fucking time! Everyone of us! Banging them down! Banging them down! If you're a fuck, tackle the ass, get up, bring the fucking...
Come on! First time this, boys! First time this! Everything first time's gonna be hard, it's gonna be fixed up, and it's gonna be fucking nasty! It's gonna be nasty today!
Don't wait for them to do something! We go there and we fucking do it!
Come on! Come on! Come on! Come on!
What?
They're feeling the pressure, making mistakes.
That's scrum, we've got to get him in the scrum.
How long?
Thank you. right, that's all right, Mo.
Don't worry about that.
That's all right, Mo.
Take it on the net drop first.
Huh?
Take it on the net drop first. You can smash it legally.
Boys, Grant.
Well done, Grant.
Well done, Grant!
Didn't see it. We there, bud.
Let me have a picture of you, bud. Come on, let's get you on here. How are you looking? Huh? You're looking good, bud. You're looking good.
What's happening? Two maids and then go to the rocks.
And he catch us in the middle of the boys. Right, two things, lads. Shush now. Switch on, yeah? Switch on now, yeah? Put things right, yeah? They are fucking slowing our ruck down all the fucking time. And we're not doing it to them. We're giving them quick ruck, and they're slowing our ruck. Yeah? We've got to fucking boss them harder at the ruck area. And if they're coming over with their hands, fucking stamp their hands out to them. Right? Line out. Swift. You've got to move about. Yeah, that was a bad score.
Yeah,
that's only one thing on the book here, Mark. It was fucking well. There's nothing in it in the line-out. All we got to do, boys, so you speak, yeah?
Stand all lads, please.
All we got to do, get to the line-out to you, yeah, because they like to get them in and the scrum. All that means is let's get fucking down, listen to Owen, listen to Alan, and let's get up. You two have got to boss the lifters on it.
Come on, everybody!
Smile, Steve.
Bargoed, uh-huh.
Well, it's Christmas time, and apparently there's no need to be afraid unless you're a young Cardiff team visiting Bargoed in the Cup, a side who have won their last 40 league matches. So how big a game for Bargoed is this? How important?
Massive. Biggest of the season, West. Biggest of the careers. How long? 20-odd years, isn't it?
20-odd years, we played the Matthews, the last big game we had here, and it's a big, good big for the town also.
Look, if I was Santa, as well as delivering a win from Bargoed, which I would love to do for
you. Want, yeah, tell me.
What exactly would you like to see Mike Reddick do with his squad this season?
Well, fetch the youngsters, huh? What's he supposed to do? Well, what Henry's supposed to have done. Now, what do you do? Get all the old players.
As part of the Gwent Dragons region, what would you hope that they would do for you in the forthcoming 12 months?
I think I have a notice that we are here, that we do exist as part of the Welsh Rugby Union structure.
And at the moment you feel excluded from that?
I think very much excluded from that, really, because I think it's becoming very insular.
So can you ever see a time in the next 12 months that you might take off with your mates or your family down to Rodney Parade and watch the Dragons?
No.
Nice succinct answer. Moving swiftly on. I'm going to grant you a Christmas wish. What is your Christmas wish for the future of the Welsh rugby in the next 12 months or so?
Well, I think it's to bring the under-90s and the 21s on and let them play rugby in the top divisions, not for them sitting on benches watching matches all the week.
Luck would have it, I've got the development officer from the Dragons and the Blues here today. How important is a game like this to Bargoed as a stepping stone to pulling on a Dragon shirt?
I mean, it's ideal. They're in the shop window. That's what the Cup rugby's all about. We've got guys here now putting their wits up against the Premier League Cardiff region. The ideal opportunity here in London.
If I could grant you a Christmas wish, what would it be?
Well, home win against England and Grand Slam.
It's been a while since we've had a Grand Slam, though, hasn't it?
Wales win the Six Nations.
already had my Christmas wish. I'm in a burger van full of beautiful women, and I got some beer. Happy Christmas. Ho, ho, ho.